Let's do a website audit. But what is it actually? And why is there a need to perform it routinely? And what tools do you need for it? I'll answer all those questions in today's video on a basic DIY website audit. Well, to put it simply, a website audit is a thorough analysis of your website. It allows you to examine your site for SEO, user experience, design, content, and technical issues. It helps you deep clean your website. Just like how you'd clean your house before a guest visits you, you want your website to look its best before visitors come to see it. As a matter of fact, performing a website audit offers you long-term benefits. For example, identifies issues that may hinder your website to rank high on the SERPs, improves your SEO and your conversion rates, increases the flow of incoming traffic, sprucifies the existing design, and eventually impacts user acquisition. It's a good idea to conduct a website audit at least twice a year. However, if you make frequent updates to your site or publish content monthly, then it's a good idea to perform a website audit every quarter. And before we dive into this video, I'd like to preface the importance of hiring a professional site auditor to do the job. We're only skimming the surface of how to perform a website audit, which in itself is quite extensive. And a professional is going to be approaching it with an expert skill level that comes with time, something that you can't just get with watching a YouTube video. But we're going to do our best to show you what you should be looking for if you are doing it yourself. But where do you begin? Well, you can pick from a bunch of free or paid tools, such as Moz, Ahrefs, SEMrush, Ubersuggest, Screaming Frog, and SE Ranking. In this video, I'll use Ahrefs' paid version to audit the Link Building HQ site. Ahrefs is a feature-rich and all-in-one SEO tool. Its site audit feature crawls websites for over 100 predefined SEO points and gives details on everything right or wrong with your website. Just like your mom pointing out every little flaw in your room. But in order to access all of Ahrefs' features, you need to pay for it. So if you have the budget, go for it. Consider it an investment. Or you can use Ahrefs' free version, the Webmaster Tools. It allows you to use the Site Audit and Site Explore features, but only for the websites you own, which can be quite limiting. But the question is, why would anyone use Ahrefs' paid version when the free Webmaster Tools exist? Because with the paid version, you can run site audits on competitors' websites as well, and get an in-depth analysis of their SEO strategy, and to perform a website audit the way we're doing it. You'd also need Keyword Explorer and Content Explorer, which aren't available in the free version. And there are other limitations as well. So pick the right tool depending on your budget and needs. Beginning the website audit process, I open Ahrefs, go to the site audit option, and let the crawl run on my website, which is already saved on my list of projects. It takes some time depending on the size of the website, but don't worry, grab a coffee, watch some cat videos on YouTube, and wait for it to finish. In case you're starting from scratch and have a new site to audit, you need to create a new project for that. Hit that orange button and add your site. Then go through the simple steps of choosing your scope, verifying ownership, picking specifics for your site audit, rank tracking, and mentioning your competitors. Schedule daily, weekly, or monthly crawls for your project. Site Audit will run these automatically and save each crawl data. While my crawl is running in the background, let's talk about the design and UX assessment. Your website's design is like a book cover. It's the first thing people see, and they can either draw them in or turn them off. You want your website to be like Harry Potter, not Barry Trotter. To study the typical user behavior of your site, use heat map generating tools. They let you see what parts of the page are drawing the most attention and clicks. And in this way, it can be a good starting point to analyze how users are interacting with your site. You can use Smart Look, Crazy Egg, or Hotjar, whichever fits your needs. Next, you can assess your website's UX by answering the following questions. How are the overall aesthetics? Appealing or annoying? Is page structure easy to distinguish and navigate? These include headers, main body, footers, titles, sidebars, top bars. Is design leading to interactive elements present on the web page? Is your media properly optimized and coherent in style? Is the user journey free of all sources of frustration? If you answered yes to most of these questions, congratulations, your website's killing it. But if you answered no, don't worry, you can still save the day by redesigning your website. Just make sure that there's consistency between fonts, styles, and colors, and no annoying pop-ups or distracting banners. But that's not it. There are more aspects that add up to a good user experience, like site speed, A/B testing, and funnel conversions. But here we focused more on the fundamentals, rather than cramming in all of the information related to UX. That could be a separate video. Let us know in the comments if that's something you'd like to see. And don't forget to subscribe and to hit that notification bell. Okay, so my website crawl is complete. Let's see what we got. The first thing I see is the overview. It shows the health score, URL crawl data, errors, and issues distribution. As I scroll down, I see all the issues listed and the total number of URLs affected by them. By clicking on View All Issues, I'm able to see issues in different sections, like internal pages, indexability, links, redirects, content, visuals, social tags, sitemaps, and others. If you click on that little question mark at the extreme right, it'll tell you how to fix the issue, and it works for every kind of SEO issue your site has. You can see the importance filter at the top, divided into error, warning, and notice, so you can set your priority and start resolving the issues accordingly. By clicking on a number beside any issue, it shows you the list of affected URLs and the relevant details. You can hit the export button and forward them to your dev team, or if you are your dev team, you can start resolving the issues. Good luck. And Site Audit not only detects issues individually, but also by category. Okay, that's enough of the overview. Let's check out the website performance option. It allows you to test the site's functionality and load times. On Ahrefs Site Audit, I go to the Performance tab, where I can see the visual breakdowns of the various page speed metrics. Each section of the page speed is clickable, and it takes you to lists of affected pages. You can easily figure out your slow pages, export the CSV, and you know the drill. SEO pros should also use Google Page Speed Insights to check the site's performance. But it only shows you a single page's performance at a time, and not the bulk data of all internal pages. So you'd have to insert a specific URL if you wanted the data for a specific page. And that could be annoying if your website had tens, hundreds, or even thousands of pages. Moving on, let's have a round of SEO check. An SEO audit will let you decide whether your website is optimized for search engines or not. It gives you the rundown of existing lackings, along with opportunities to rank better and to bring in more traffic. On Ahrefs, to check your indexed pages, go to the indexability report and have a look at your total number of internal pages, indexable pages, and non-indexed pages. Don't worry, they're not being held in SEO jail. They're just grounded at the moment. All figures in numeric data are clickable, which allows you to see how many of your pages are registered by Google and what's the reason why the rest are not. Now it's time to check the keywords, bringing in large amounts of organic traffic. For that, I'm using Site Explorer. By clicking on the organic keywords, I can see all the keywords my website's ranking for. It also gives you the details of volume, keywords, CPC, traffic, and other important metrics. To find new keyword opportunities, you can use the Keyword Explorer on the top. It allows you to see thousands of keywords in seconds for Google, YouTube, Amazon, and many other platforms. To find which pages are doing best on the SERPs, go to the Top Pages option. This will let you see which of your pages are receiving the most organic traffic. Conducting an SEO audit provides a good outlook on your website. With the right data, you can classify your best performing pages and keywords, find new keyword opportunities, and plan your new content accordingly. Let's talk about content, the stuff that makes your website worth visiting. But not all content is created equal, and that's where content assessment comes in. where you can remove the underperforming low-quality content and elevate the high-quality content to superstar status. On Ahrefs, the Content tab lets you see all the existing issues of metas, headings, and word count. Then check out the Duplicates tab to remove the unnecessary content clones stealing the spotlight. To find out what kind of content is working or not, go to Site Explorer and check out Top Content and Top Pages. This will give you a good idea of what's most popular with your target audience and what new content pieces you should be creating. Speaking of content ideas, check out the Content Explorer on the top bar. Find new opportunities and to check out what kind of articles get the most traffic in referring domains. And yes, it's also important to assess website content for the following things. Does it follow Double Eat and other important Google updates? Is there a need to repurpose or update previous content according to the latest trends? What are the incompetencies seen in the content compared to competitors' websites? This will help you garner pristine data and execute necessary actions like alter, remove, or improve your content. And in case you're unfamiliar with Double Eat or the other content-related updates, check out our other videos here. Moving on to last, but certainly not least, backlink profile assessment. In Ahrefs, backlink research is just at the next level. Having the biggest index of over 35 trillion backlinks, it's one of the best tools for backlink profile assessment. I go to Site Explorer and click Overview. It shows the number of referring domains and backlinks. You can compare this data to your competitors and figure out how many more quality backlinks you might need. Next, I go to the Backlinks option. Here, I can see all new and lost backlinks, and a whole lot of essential data which can help me strengthen my backlink profile. Choose to only see do follow or no follow. You can pick a backlink type as well. You can also see broken backlinks, and if by chance you have any, proceed to take the necessary actions, like asking the host to change the link or setting up 301 redirects. Now let's talk about anchor texts. Go to the Anchors option on the sidebar and look out for any spammy or dodgy anchor texts. If you end up seeing some irrelevant or unexpected stuff, just click on that anchor text, check out the full report, and investigate further. Lastly, check out Best by Links report. This shows you the web pages that attract the most links from different domains. This gives you a clear idea of what content type gets noticed more than the others. In addition, you can generate the same report for competitors and detect linkable content ideas that you're missing out on. Wrapping this up, analyzing your backlink profile is extremely important because backlinks are vital for ranking and building authority. Remember, the choice of audit tool depends on your specific needs and budget. However, if you're looking for every SEO tool feature under the sun and have the budget to match, Ahrefs is the tool for you, even though they are not sponsoring this video. Nobody's sponsoring us. So, no matter what tool you use, frequent website audits are necessary. They ensure that your site is up to date, issue-free, and that it conforms to SEO standards. It's in your best interest to make sure that you're keeping up with this important facet of your SEO, whether you're doing it yourself or hiring a professional. Did you know that every time someone subscribes to our channel, a kitten is saved? Every time our notification bell is rung, a unicorn lays an egg. Every time one of our videos is liked, I dance the dance of my ancestors.